Hey peeps, welcome back to the channel. Today we're playing Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. I am Parky P. Let's get right into the game. I've heard typically good things about the game. Not played it myself, not really seen any gameplay about it either. So I just thought I would jump in, see how it is. See if it's good enough to play, see if it's good enough to watch. Supposed to be quite the pretty game as well.
Hello. Who are you? Doesn't matter. Welcome. You're safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others.
Oh, this is weird. Got headphones in.
Her story has already come to an end, but now.
And they're really making use of the perspectives.
It's breathing. It's breathing. It's breathing. He knows she's getting closer. He can feel her coming closer. She's getting this is a journey deep into darkness.
It's like the whispering into my ears.
Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. That's not quite true. Some are old, some are new. They've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Can you see them? Over there.
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
She's in hell. Look. Up ahead. You see it too?
You promised you'd get
it. Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell.
Go back.
Oh, the audio design on this game so far. It's like I've got voices inside my head. And that's not a bad thing, I'm enjoying it. There was a warning that popped up before the game loaded up itself.
Look around and you'll see them. The drowned, the sick, the
slain. Try not to speak while they're speaking. Yeah, a warning that this picks psychosis.
They're going to do that to you. Can you see them?
And that,
can you see them? They're going to do that to you.
Basically, it's a fictitious take on psychosis.
They're watching.
Which is a mental health issue.
Can you feel them watching? They're watching her.
But the way the audio's been designed so far, it makes it feel like there are voices inside your head.
Can you feel it? What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds on
that's the I'll let her finish speaking. With the graphics popping up for the credits, the display is actually reflected in the water instead of just its own thing. So you can just see it around now, around where the oar was.
You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her.
Yeah, it's there. See? I'm getting serious God of War vibes so far as well, especially the start of that game.
Don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Oh, this is... The audio design so far has been fantastic. It really draws you into the game. I can't do anything other than walk, right? Ooh, I can do a bit of a sprint.
Focus, focus, and you'll see. What happens if you focus?
Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hell's Gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river. And will find a bridge covered in gold. The path to Hellblade goes from there.
I can hear things around. So I'll just keep pressing forward. Jesus, the audio design, it makes it feel like there's so many people in your head or on top of you. It's almost claustrophobic. Genuinely thought someone was going to pop up, but
did you see it?
It's just people in my head.
Thank you.
whose head is this? So I'm assuming Dillian is the head currently attached to our hip. This game looks stunning so far as well. Look at this sideways walk we've got going on. Such a pretty game. What's that shoes on? Got some type of shoe on. So many people in my head.
But she does remember that only the dead may cross it. That part wasn't so easy to forget. The old fool said there was a hidden path up to it. Let's see, shall we?
So this is clearly based on Norse mythology, which again helps with the God of War vibes, or the recent God of War anyway. Which I've just finished watching through myself. Didn't play through it, watched it from Jacksepticeye. Really great series, I'd recommend watching it. Ooh, hello. There's another one of them stone medallion things.
The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of the Northmen.
Oh, I didn't realize I'd restart it. Alright, we'll keep going.
Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim. And that is where you must travel.
So I don't know if you could hear it over the narrator there, but as I was climbing up the ladders, I could hear the voices inside my head saying, "Don't look down, don't look down, don't look down." It's just little touches like that that, so far, have made this game really stand out. I get that it is a lot of walking about so far, not a lot of action.
You don't know where you're going.
Oh God. I hope this is getting picked up in the video. I'll have to watch this back, and if you can't really hear it, then I will definitely turn the volume up itself.
Get down. What's she waiting for?
I also like how there's no button prompts so far either.
She shouldn't have done it. She can't go back now. No, this is it.
I'm literally just guessing, so to climb the ladder it was to press A. drop down there was press A, but to focus on things, it's right trigger. So it's not holding your hand so far. Oh, just knock on the door. Talk this way.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
I can see you.
Okay. I've actually got to move about. I mean, well, that's it, surely. Yeah, so surely it was. Oh, it's the bloody shadow. So it was actually still there. So I can't actually press anything there. Oh, it's open now. Okay. See, I thought.
The gate is open. Go through the gate. Go
yeah, we're going through the gate.
It worked.
Yeah, I thought it'd be.
God's sake.
Yeah, I thought it'd be just like a little part on the gate or something like that. But for it to actually be an element in the game design itself, a shadow, it's just clever. So she's definitely hearing all these voices as well. Senua. Oh, this game's gorgeous. But for me, so far, it's the audio design. The audio design stands out above anything else. It's fantastic.
I guess it's the same with heights. You can stand on the edge, pretend it's going to be okay. But you know that death is near, waiting for you.
Wait, what? Okay, so I can't just press on. Oh my god. Oh dear. Why is crossing a bridge a challenge? I'm literally fighting against her moving, well, trying to jump off the bloody edge. Jesus.
The world of the dead is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side, and
everything else over here.
Her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness,
just the bridge,
age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the nine worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed, and with her, you must bargain.
So we're off to see Hela to try and get Dillion back, which is the head on our hip. Is this a nice safe place? Please. In a fight now. Yes? Sorry.
I'll give you what you want. I won't resist it. Just give him back.
What? What the hell? We are not having the best of it here. So am I doing the move? No, I'm not doing the movement. Oh, hello. Hello there. Oh, there's more. Okay. Right, so that's how we dodge. Kick him. I took him down. I'm enjoying the gameplay so far as well, actually. The combat. It seems very Dark Souls-esque. Oh, God. So, oh, what? Oi, do one, mate. Was that my dad? Come on, Senua. What? So have I died? I've died. I haven't died. I'm so confused.
A vision.
What?
Poor Senua. The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head. The seed of the soul. Until there is nothing left of her.
No.
All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time.
I was gonna say, is that like a respawn element? So every time that you die in combat, it's playing out as just a vision instead. The dark will rot will grow each time you fail. If the rot reaches Sinla's head, a quest is over. What? Oh no. Oh, I didn't realize that.
The hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost.
Oh, I can't take this stress. Okay, and we will carry on with that in the next episode. Oh, this game so far, man. It's... I've still got voices talking inside my head. Oh, I'm looking forward to playing some more of this. And I'm hoping that we don't lose all of our progress by dying too many times. Pro gamers on. Yeah, I've been Parky P. If you've liked the video, give it a like. Comment what you have liked, what you haven't liked. But most importantly, make sure to hit that subscribe button. We're definitely going to be playing some more Hellblade. God, the audio in this game. If you are going to play this game, I fully recommend playing it with headphones. But yeah, I've been Parky P, and I shall see you all next time.